Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you want to see my upcoming new tutorials, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. This is the 12th and final episode about Vue Basics. In the previous episode, we worked on custom form validation, and today we'll work on tabs. First of all, open your text editor and open producttab.vue, which we had created in our previous session. Instead of just showing div, let's add div class tabs. Let's remove this h1 tag and instead let's add div with a class called tablinks. And to show each tab link, we're gonna add span. In the data, we will add tabs array where we will show reviews and make a review. We will now use this string in this span using v4, but before that, let's add a class called tab and then let's use v4 tab in tabs. In the key, let's add index. So let's modify this to tab and index. And we want to show tab. Check the site now. At the bottom, you will see tabs with reviews and make a review. Now, the next step is to know which tab is selected. So just after this tab, you can add selected tabs and you can initialize it to reviews. Now let's add click event on this span. You can say selected tabs equal tab, which will either select reviews or make a review. Then let's also change its visual aspect using class binding. The class I want to use is ActiveTab and show this class whenever selected tabs equals tab. Check the site again and this time in the tab you can see the active state is working. If you click on make a review, it will get selected, and if you click on reviews, it will get selected. Great. Now let's add our tab content, which will either show content for this reviews or content for this make a review. So in this product tab component, let's add a div with a class called tab content. And currently all our tab content is under our product component. So open your product component and you can copy this div class review and this product review. Also, you can copy this product tab and paste it inside this container div. Now, since this product review is under this product tab component, let's cut it from here and paste it in our product tab component. Check the site now. And everything goes blank over here. If you check the console, you will see an error message over here saying property or method reviews is not defined. If you look at the template, we are using review, but it's coming from our product component. So we have to pass the data into our product tabs using reviews and pass the reviews. Now, on our product tab component, we have to use the props. We are using the views. The type would be array. And require is true. Check the site now. And this time it is showing as it should be. But if you click on any of the item, currently it is showing both reviews and make a review. If you want to conditionally show each of them, then in this product tab component, we have to use vshow and then use selected tabs equal reviews. So this means whenever the selected tab is reviews, we're gonna show this reviews. Likewise, let's copy this one and paste it over here and then show this product review whenever it is make a review. Check the site again. And this time the tab is working, but we still have one issue to resolve. And that is property or method addReview is not defined on the instance. I will try to explain you on our view tab. So now product review is child of this product tab, which is child of product. In other words, product review is grandchild of product, and currently our app is not set up to communicate with grandchild from grandparent. So we can now remove this addReview method, and instead we want to implement global channel through which we can send information. We call this channel event pass, and it will be a new view instance. I will simply add them in our main.js. It will be something like this. Now open the product review component, and first let's import event pass from main.js, and here instead of this $emit, let's use event pass $emit. We also need to use event pass in our product component, so first let's import them. Now we no longer use this addReview method, but we will be using same logic, so cut that out and delete the rest. Then we will add mount it at the bottom. It is a lifecycle hook. We will learn more about this in our upcoming session, but for now, just know that mounted is a place to put the code which you want to run as soon as component is mounted to the DOM. Here, we will use event pass, which will listen to review submitted event, then it will take product review and it will do exactly as it was doing before. So you can paste the code. Check the site again. And click on make a review, and let's make one review over here. Click on submit. And now we can see our review over here. Great. This is the end of this final session. Feel free to comment below if you have any question. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you so much for choosing my YouTube channel to learn few basics. I will see you again next time with the next course. If you want some hosting companies, you can check the link in the description below. Thank you and see you soon.